Hello everybody, Carla Nicole. So if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, you are missing out. Go over to the Carla Nicole Wisdom channel after you watch this and make sure to subscribe. So hello everybody, I'm Carla Nicole. I'm a wisdom coach, and I am always going to give a unique perspective with a twist of wisdom. So today, I'm very excited, very excited, very excited to talk about detaching. Hey, Milan, happy Sunday to you, love. So I'm very happy about talking about the art of detachment. How do we detach on some stuff, man? I don't know. You know, a lot of times in life, we get attached to things, and a lot of times we get attached to things that are unhealthy, just not good for us. There are times that we get attached to things that are just not to our best interest, but yet we stay on being attached to it, whether it's good or not. It's like, look, this is not good for you. Even food, clothing, people, right? Scenarios, you know, we get attached to a lot of things in life. And so I want to talk about this because the art of detaching is really key in this lifetime to be able to move forward. A lot of times we'll find ourselves in our life stagnant, and we don't really know why we're stagnant. We're just stagnant. We're not able to progress. We're not able to move forward. And a lot of times we can't move forward because of the fact we're attached to something that's really weighing down our opportunity to do that, okay? So I'm going to tell you what actually inspired me to do the art of detachment today. So I see a lot of ladies, just when you go through a heartbreak, you know, they call a woman scorn, right? When we go through a heartbreak, or we're upset, or we're frustrated about a love that we lost. And a lot of times, women will do something drastic, and some of it is cutting their hair. They will literally cut all of their hair off, like just buzz it off, or they'll clip it off, or they'll go to the hair salon and be like, cut it off. I don't want my hair anymore. And so that's an extreme. Okay. You're cutting off your hair is an extreme, but I'm understanding those that have done this has talked about how there is a freeing. There is a newfound, I don't know, amazing feeling of freedom inside them, because they are detaching from their luxurious hair or the hair they had while they were in the relationship with the love of their life, you know. And so I was like, wow, you know. And I've talked to many women that, you know, have the bald thing going or the shortcuts and all that. I'm like, those are some bad cuts, man. Those are sharp. And a lot of women will tell me, yeah, I cut it because I was, you know, a woman scorned, but now I love my cut. I love my short hair. And so, and some of them can rock it. Like, y'all are beautiful doing that. So when you sit down and you look at women, you're like, wow, like you did that. And you didn't even take a second look back at, you know, being attached to your hair like that. So that's like one of the ways to which I want to talk about that. We'll just buzz our hair off, or we'll just be like, I'm done with him and I'm through with him. So I'm just going to cut all my hair off. And like I said, that's an extreme. But when you see women that have cut all their hair off, you have noticed, like, wow, when they talk about the freedom that they came into themselves, finding themselves through the buzzing of each time they buzz their hair. I saw Sanaa Lathan talk about how she even did it for a movie. She buzzed all her hair off and she said it was freeing. She was crying. That was all natural. She really did that for a movie scene. And she talked about how there's an attachment to hair. Okay, so I get it. So a lot of times women will, like I said, will get it, will be scorned and angry and upset. And like, I'm done with him and I'm going to change my hair. And they do that. Get it. Okay. And then they move on, right? Because for some reason, The attachment to the hair is a reminder of either what he was so attracted to, and they're like, you know what? Hey, Sylvia. They're attracted to the hair, and she's just done with it. She just doesn't even want to acknowledge that that's why they were in the relationship to begin with. And I get it. But this is what inspired this live today, because I want to talk about how powerful it is that we don't really realize we have attachments to a lot of stuff. Okay, I'm going to even use my son as example. Love him to death. And my son is 10. You know, I talk about him and my 19-year-old daughter all the time. But my son, okay, so we're having an issue between he and I where we'll wash his clothes and I'll tell him, son, those pants, you got to let them go. They're done. You can't wear those anymore. Those are too small. Oh, no, Mom. Like, I don't want to not wear those pants. Like, son, they're on your ankles. You got to let them go. I get you all these nice new pants and stuff. You can wear the new now. Let it go. It's okay to be attached to those, but I need you to let it go. It's done. And he's just like, oh, Mom, you know, I don't want to do all that. I don't, you know, I really like those pants or whatever. And I try to explain to him, I get it. But son, you are in the growing phase. And so you're going to grow. You're going to outgrow your 10 and 12s and you're going to go into your 14, 16s. You're going to outgrow these things. So you got to let them go. I'm sorry that it really is frustrating for you. But now I want to talk about everybody. Don't we stay in relationships too long? Come on, people. Do we not stay in relationship way past the expiration date? We knew the relationship was done. Listen, we knew the relationship was done way before we say we're done. But we keep trying to stay in a relationship. I'm going to stay in it for the kids. I'm going to stay in it because, you know, she can't do without me or he can't live without me. I'm going to stay in it for all these other outside reasons. And you and I both know the relationship is over. Why are you sitting in that relationship you no longer fit? That's like still wearing a clothes that you no longer fit. Like my son still walking around in pants he can't fit anymore. That's how we look when we're in relationships we no longer can be growing in. And see, here's the thing. A lot of times, I tell my clients all the time, a lot of times we are in relationships that we get all snug and comfortable in. And, oh my God, this feels good. But then as we age, as we progress, as we learn about ourselves, as we start advancing, we start to move forward in our lives. A lot of times we start to outgrow our partner and we don't know what to do with that. Like, he doesn't get my newfound awareness of me. He doesn't understand that I want to do, I don't know, pottery, or I want to become a new opera singer or something that he would have never imagined you to be. And now all of a sudden you're like, I'm going to drop all my weight. I'm going to be, matter of fact, case in point, there was a woman I saw not too long ago. She was 250 pounds. Now she done dropped to a buck 10. He's like, I don't want no man looking at you. That's my buck 10. And all this stuff is like, okay, I get it. But understand, your wife has transformed. She detached from her weight. She detached from who she was. And now she has advanced into a newfound level of herself. And so since she's become a newfound level of herself, you are taking issue with that. Like, I have an issue with her growing. Well, here's the thing. Understand something. If your mate is growing, your mate is growing into a newfound level of themselves. Guess what, baby boy or baby girl? You now need to seek and find your new level of you. Because what happens is in relationships, we get so snug. Like I said, we get snug and comfortable in our relationship. But as soon as our mate or as soon as our lover or as soon as our person we're in a relationship with changes who we got with to some new person, we're like, who are you? We don't want to actually get to know the newfound person because we're aggravated. Well, I didn't get with you because of this. You know, this is not, you're not who I knew. You're not who I wanted you to be. Okay, but understand, change. Remember I said last time? Change is often. Change happens all the time. We are constantly changing. I talk about my gray in my hair. My hair is graying right now as we speak. So guess what? I'm changing. So the man that I might be with will be like, I love her with her brown hair, but it may turn silver. You gonna love me less now because my hair's silver? I mean, this is what I'm saying. So we really need to understand the power and the art of detaching. It's not hard to do, but we have to start learning early on that if something is no longer fitting in your life, be it a relationship, be it things, be it car, you know, we will stay in a car so long that the wheels fall off. You know that car is no longer doing what you need it to do. You have to pray every morning before you start your car up that it starts. That is too much. Understand, it is now time to go ahead and invest and get you another car. These are things, but these are also techniques we need to learn early on, how we detach and get away from things that we get so attached to. And a lot of times we don't want to admit it. See, we don't want to admit that we're attached to something, right? We know, as parents, we know that we hold on to the fact that our babies are grown. It's hard, as far as for me, my baby had a baby. So, you know, I remember her this big and now she's this big with her own. Okay, so do I still consider her a baby? No, I had to learn to allow her to grow into the woman she's becoming. And in that allowance, there is a level of detaching from being overly, attached to the younger version of her. So if I still see my daughter as a child holding on to a teddy bear and telling me, mommy, I need some milk, and she's now a grown woman with her own job, with her own goals, with her own life, with her own child and her own boyfriend, her own goals, I'm not serving her well, because my image in my mind of who my daughter is not fitting who she is. So guess what? I actually treat her like she's a baby, and that is not okay. There are so many people treating young teenagers, young girls, young grown women like babies. It's like, no, I understand that that's always going to be quote unquote your baby. I get that. But we cannot be attached solely to the image of when they were a baby, that we don't let go and allow them to become who they are as an adult. As parents, we have a tendency to get caught up in that. And then we're like, oh my God, my baby's doing this and my baby's doing that. Honey, that child is not a baby. That child is 35 years old. Why are you still calling that man, that grown man, a baby? Well, he's always going to be my baby. Yes. But understand, you are treating him like a child, because when you talk to him, you talk to him and advise him like he's still a baby. You can't do that. You have to now allow yourself ways and understanding that you have to now get acquainted and engaged with the new version of who your child is. We got to see past always thinking, oh my God, my baby this and my baby that. That's fine, but we got to get past that, and we got to see past understanding that our children must grow. And when they grow, it comes a point where we have to say, okay, how do I love you, take care of you, advise you as a grown person, and no longer try to advise you like you're a teenager? How do I do that? Because there is a newfound understanding of doing some stuff as a parent and teaching and parenting on a whole different level. Because understand, we are now advisors as parents when our kids are grown. We're advisors, and we try to, what? We try to advise and try to encourage. That's a whole nother level of parenting. The parenting style is not the same as when they're in the house and still a baby, or still a young child, or a teenager, or a toddler. That's when we have to take all, I mean, we have to have sole proprietorship over that child. We don't have to do that once they're grown. So understanding this, it's important. I think this is very important, that we see past being so attached to certain things. And like I said, it's not hard to detach. It's just we have to take the mental notes. We have to begin to self-reflect. Oh, Lord Jesus, self-reflection. That is not easy to do, is it? To step outside of ourselves and look at ourselves and say, ooh, I'm doing some things not too kosher. Or I'm doing some things that I need to make changes with. I'm doing some things that maybe isn't beneficial to the way I'm interacting with my child or interacting with my kids. So I'm finding myself just doing things as a parent, like, you need to do this and you need to do that, and be like, ooh, maybe I need to change my tone. Because I'm still talking to my child that is now 35, like she's 17. And that's unacceptable. We have to learn the way we present what we say and how we advise certain things to our kids, that we do it in a tone where we're not trying to be bossy. We're just trying to make suggestions. You make the final call. I'm just trying to give you suggestions and make your life a little easier from my perspective. And then let it go. And then let them make the final decision. They're going to make their mistakes. They're not always going to agree with you. Matter of fact, a lot of times you're not even going to be the source of truth for a while. They're not going to come to you until they really say, ooh, I done made some mistakes trying to do it myself, and now I need to go back to my mama or to my dad and talk to them about some things I made some bad calls on. And that's fine. But a lot of times we don't want to really truly be honest that we are attached with some things that no longer fit in our life. Even our jobs. I'm going to talk about jobs for a minute. Lord have mercy. Jobs, right? We're in jobs. We're in an employed state with a company or corporation or whatever. And it's been great. It's been good. It's taking care of your kids, your expenses. It's taking care of a lot of things. Your job, right? Hey, love, it's taking a lot of care of your babies. And through the years, you know, I've been at my company for, hey, good morning, Carolyn. I've been at my job now for 19 years. And I'm like, whew, it's a long time to be at a job. You know what I'm saying? And so for those of you in a job and you're starting to feel like you're outgrowing the job, you know, it's okay. That is your truth. So what I want to encourage you is, if you're starting to feel a little bit like, ooh, this is a tight fit, this don't fit me no more, or ooh, you know, this is getting to be too small, this job is too small for me, you got to start looking inside you. If you feel like you can create something, or you have a hobby you love to do, and you have something that's a talent, remember I talked about your gifts, you found something that you really are driven to do without really taking an effort, hey, consider doing something part-time or full-time that you really love to do. I mean, we don't have forever on the planet. We don't. We don't have forever here. So to devote years and years and years and years and years in a job that has you feeling confined and tight, and you're like, I'm just not feeling like challenged anymore. I'm feeling like, you know, it's a job. I'm doing it. I'm paying my bills, but it's not, I'm no longer in love with this job. Think about it. Create. Tell my kids that all the time. Create. If you have a hobby or something you love to do, consider doing it full time. Who's stopping you? Listen, we don't have forever here. So, you know, the time we got is the time we have. And it's a blessing. But my thing is, I'm looking like, 19 years, bruh, that's cool and all, but handing over another 19, I don't know about that. And it gets to a point where you have to just look at yourself. You have to now look and see what is fitting in your life. What fits? I'm even talking about down to things. Is it time to change the decor in your house? Is it time to, you know, my dad said something powerful to me. You know, he said, you need to do some things in your home to where you get uncomfortable. I said, uncomfortable. He said, yeah, do some things that make you uncomfortable. In other words, make some changes in your house. Change it. You know, so I started doing that. I said, okay, So I'm going to change the core pretty often. I'm going to make it uncomfortable where I don't always see the same thing over and over and over again. Because you got to get uncomfortable to start to grow. And I thought, I love that. And I'm going to tell my, you know, the people that watch my life, I'm going to tell them to do that. Start making minor changes. Start doing some cleanups. You know, if you have, and we all do, I have one. If you have a junk drawer, and we all have one, go through that junk drawer and clean it out. Get it out of there. Start cleaning out your junk drawers. Start making some minor changes. You know, if you've been wearing that same, I don't know, that same, you've had that same bedroom set forever, get a new one. Do some things that make you feel like, you know, life is in abundance. Life has now challenged you to be the best version of yourself. Not for nobody else, but for you. Because see, we have a tendency to be attached to things. And then we're like, well, now that I've detached from what I thought I loved so much, I'm finding that there's a newfound love that I didn't know I was going to love. Because now I made myself uncomfortable. And now I have put myself in a new environment. Friends. We have some friends that we're attached to that are so toxic in our life that we know that this friend is really not truly a friend. They're really not someone that really cares about your rise. They're really not somebody that wants to see you blossom. Matter of fact, they're so jealous of you that they don't really know what to do with who you are or how you're doing or any of that. They really don't know. They really have not came to a point where they're like, I really want to be here and be in a arrangement with you as a friend to where I want to see that you care about my rise because I care about yours. But a lot of times you're not really positive about what I'm doing, about who I'm becoming. Once again, we got friends that we can't fit no more. Like, like they're a friend that we're still trying to fit like a tight little, like we're trying to put on a onesie because this friendship was cool when we were 10. But as we grew older, we outgrew each other. It's no love loss. It's just that we didn't have the same aspirations. We no longer talk the same. You know, our taste in what we find fun is different. I may want to go to a jazz spot or go out and have some tea and you want to go turn up at the rock concert. We're on a different vibe. Doesn't mean I love you no less. It just means that we have different taste here. And because of the differences, we're going to find ourselves just not, I don't know. We're just not in the same culturally. We're not the same or similar. So we're finding ourselves in this, you know, bumpiness because we can't get along. We can't see eye to eye. So it gets to a point where we have to sit back and say, okay, if something no longer fits in my life, what do I need to do? You need to detach. Detachment doesn't mean you have to be hateful. Detachment doesn't mean you have to be, guarded. But sometimes when we need to detach from some things, we can do so by saying, you know what? Let me say, for instance, we have this, you know, this car we love. We've had it forever. And, you know, I really don't want just anybody getting it. So what do I need to do? Well, pass it to somebody that needs a car. Make that their new car, their new vehicle. And then guess what? You're like, oh, well, damn. Now I see that my car is taken care of by somebody who respects it, who takes care of it. So I'm no longer feeling frustrated by the fact that that my car is gone, that I'm now passing it on to someone else. I'm telling you, man, there's so many people that's attached to stuff and they need to let go that they have a hard time letting go of. And again, like I said, being attached to something that is no longer fitting in your life, man, it's very burdening and it's a heavy weight. And like I said, if you don't learn to detach from people that really are not benefiting your life, then you'll find yourself in between a rock and a hard place. You'll find yourself yourself in between a rock and a hard place. You'll find yourself like, man, I love my spouse, but we don't fit no more. What do I do? Well, you know, for me, I always encourage people to blossom and to basically stay focused on trying to make the relationship work as much as you can. You know, divorce is not something that I encourage at all. It's like one of the most detrimental experiences I think anybody on the planet can have. But I do want to say this. If you are both not growing, it's going to be harder. Good morning, Mookie. If you are both not growing in the relationship, it's going to be hard for the relationship to grow. I'm going to leave you guys with this. And you know, I'm big about intimacy and lovemaking. A lot of times when you are in an intimacy with someone, we oftentimes are so busy focusing on just having the orgasm or having the blissful romantic scene before the orgasm and all this. We want all that stuff, right? But we never really think about, what am I gaining in my life from the person I'm intimate with? Am I getting more creative? Do I feel more empowered to be the best version of myself because of this person? Or am I just okay with being mediocre? Or am I okay because I have them now that I'm not going to work hard on me? That's not acceptable. The person you're with should be inspiring you to be the best version of who you are. Period. That's really the hidden joy of intimacy. If you're not getting from the person you're with, your partner, your lover, your spouse, whatever, if you're not getting to the point where you're feeling like, I want to be the best me I can be, not just because of me, but because they inspire me to be that, then you're not intimate with the right person. And see, it takes a long time for us to really sit down and stay rooted in that thinking. We think that sex is just about being intimate and the joy of it and the acts of it and the different ways we can do it and what can we put on and what kind of things we can do to do it. That's all cool. But no, after the sex, what are you getting? What are you getting from this person? Are they getting you to where you're jumping out of the bed and be like, I'm going to create some stuff. I'm going to get up and create some stuff. I'm going to write. I'm going to be all about that person charged me up. I'm now wanting to be the best version of me because of them being with me. And then that person is charged up like, oh, I can't be mediocre. I got to be the best version of myself. That's what you're supposed to get when you are in a relationship with somebody. If you're not getting that, then, of course, you're getting very little. And so you need to be mindful of that. Let's see what Carolyn says. She says, I've had to do that, and it's been the hardest thing to do. Not only from significant others, but also from toxic family members. It's taking me a while to understand why I've had to do it, but I need to move forward. I love them, but it's my time now. Okay, so here's the thing, Carolyn. I love that you're talking about that. This is the thing. You are going through a transition, okay? Carolyn, you're going through a transition in your life to where you're now taking charge of your life. Be proud in it. Don't feel that it is a bad thing. That is a great thing. Let me tell you something. One thing that you'll learn, that drug addicts, alcoholics, people that are toxic, those people are chasing peace. Simulated peace. Simulated peace is drunkenness. Simulated peace is getting high. Simulated peace is great sexual experiences. Those are all simulated versions of peace. But it's not peace. It's simulated. You are now finding that you want to have peace in your life. And now that you understand how high you can get by having peace, you're going to do every darn doggone thing you can to protect the peace. So with that said, if you are detaching from people that are toxic, that's fine, baby girl. Do it, because I'm going to tell you why. As you are slowly detaching from people that are not no longer fitting in your life because they are too small. I know that sounds terrible, but remember I told you earlier about my son and his pants being too small. Well, when I talk about clothes being too small, people can become too small. Relationships can become too small. Things in your home can become too small. Your home can become too small. All of these things that are no longer fitting in your life, you must make a decision and be okay in it. Make your decision that, hey, I'm going to make a decision to be okay with saying you no longer fit here. And I know it's a very uncomfortable place, but now you can start to do new acquaintances and new friendships and connect with other family members that maybe take on your same life taste, your same taste of what you want to find enjoyment in. If they don't fit, let it go. Just let it go, I'm telling you. But I'm out of here, guys. Listen, I appreciate you guys joining me this afternoon. Like I said, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel is Carla Nicole Wisdom Channel. Go over there today. I need 6 more people to get my URL. I got 94 subscribers. I need 6 more people to go over there and help me get this URL. Okay? So, 6. I need 6 of you to go over there and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Why is it so hard for you guys to subscribe over there? I am confused. Y'all sit up here, you listen to me every Sunday, but it's like pulling teeth to get you guys to join my YouTube channel. And I got plenty of stuff. You can sit up there, I'm telling you now, you can sit over there and prop your feet up, get you a cup of tea, and watch video after video after video of stuff that I'm talking about. But I'm talking about intimacy, I'm talking about wisdom things, I'm talking about inspiration, I'm talking about all kinds of stuff. You are missing out if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel. I need you guys, every one of y'all in here today, go over there, Carla Nicole Wisdom Channel, and subscribe today. Come on, man. You guys are hurting my feelings. You're hurting my feelings. Okay? So anyway, listen, I am so glad you guys are here. And like I said, it is very important that you guys make sure to understand, detach from some stuff. It's okay. It is okay to let things go. Matter of fact, when you let some things go that is no longer healthy in your life, you gain so much more peace, joy, strength, serenity. I can go on and on. You gain so much more when you let that stuff go. And when it no longer fits, just let it go. I'm trying to tell you. So anyway, I'm out of here, everybody. My son is letting me know I'm over time. So I'm out of here, all of you guys. I love you guys. Thank you so much for joining me. I am Carla Nicole. I'm signing off. Come on, son. You're silly. Best kept. Have a good day. Bye.